YouTube. For those of you stopping by for the first time, you know what to do. Hit that little red subscribe button. Show your support for the channel. For those of you that have been here before, welcome back, my friends. I appreciate you stopping by to see me. Welcome back to TLTG Reviews. So, did Invictus Legend review last night. Picking up pretty good steam, decent amount of views. Enjoy the fragrance quite a bit. A lot of excitement going on in TLTG Reviews Fragrance Lounge, the Facebook group. Links in the description. Go ahead and join. We've been having some fun in there the last couple of days. It has grown exponentially. When I first got involved with the group a few days ago, it was at 98 members. It's currently at 176 members, so it's almost doubled in size in the last 3 days, 4 days, something like that. Some successful raffles today. Of course, those of you that are in the Facebook groups know we're not allowed to call them raffles. They're waffles. Some weird thing Facebook has. But anyways, speaking of, we actually have one live right now, 10 spots, $4.50 a spot for one of the fragrances in this video. And we'll discuss it when we get to it because we're going to go in order. So what are we talking about today? My favorite line. You know me. I'm the Invictus fanboy. It was time, now that I've completed the line, to have a line talk. Paco Rabanne's Invictus line. I don't have Aqua 2016. I want it, but I don't want to pay that much. The resellers are just asking so much. Don't get me wrong, there's tons of fragrances out there that cost that much or more, and I'm trying to justify it because the collector in me really wants to get it. But I digress. Let's get to the ones I do have. So, first in the line, the Originator, the first fragrance from the line released in 2012, my absolute favorite fragrance on the market that I've ever smelled and that I own. If I could only have one fragrance for the rest of my life, it's Invictus by Paco Rabanne. I love this fragrance. It's my favorite, not my first bottle, definitely won't be my last. This is sweet aquatic, it's a powerhouse, it's a screamer, it's loud, it's look at me. It's not a subtle fragrance in any way, it's a compliment magnet, undoubtedly, as the line seems to be. People like how this smells in the air. I like how they smell on skin and in the air. If you want to fill a room, I don't know about your skin, but on my oily skin, you spray these bad boys heavy, it's going to get you noticed. I fill a room when I go six sprays and beyond with this one. It lasts all day. 12-hour fragrance. Fantastic scent. It's copied, replicated, duplicated. All of these have wonderful sprayers. God, that's such a beautiful scent. This is one that's, God, I smell it still wafting in the air. This is one that gets a lot of hate. It's very polarizing because some people say it's too sweet. There's other fragrances that smell like it. Armaf Rixos has a beautiful bottle. Hawass is the biggest one that people say, oh, that's the Originator. I don't care. This is great. It's readily available. It's a decent price. It's cheaper than Hawass at the discount sites. This is a must-buy to me. There was somebody in the fragrance group earlier posted the question, if you could only keep one fragrance in your collection, what would it be? I was the first comment. It was no debate, no thought. This is it. This is what I'm going to grab. No doubt about it. This is versatile enough and strong enough to go year-round. It is. This can be a signature fragrance for you. If I wasn't so into fragrances, I could have just the one. If I had to get rid of all of them tomorrow and keep one, this is the one. But enough about my love for this one. Let's move on down the line. So this is what started everything. The original Invictus in 2012. What came out next was Invictus Intense. I believe it was 2014 or 2015. I didn't double check the year. I want to say 2015. This is a sweeter, boozy amber version of it. It has a whiskey note, has some extra amber, and it's a bit more sweet. This is better for the fall, winter, early spring, colder months. This is a 50 ml bottle. A little bit darker. It's the smallest one I have in the line. Haven't worn it that much. I wore it a little bit in the spring when I got it. It's about to get some heavier rotation as it starts to cool down. You can technically wear this in the summer. One, two sprays at most, because this is another one. Screamer. 12-hour fragrance. Loud as can be. Look at me fragrance. A little bit sweeter. People say it's kind of redundant to the original Invictus that it smells so much like it. And yes, all of these, you smell the original's DNA. They're flankers of the original. A true flanker, you're gonna smell the original in it. That's just how it goes. Some of these other flankers from other lines that they smell nothing like the original, it's a different fragrance. It's not a flanker. It's a totally different fragrance, and they're building off the name and the hype and the success of the name that they're calling a flanker. These are true flankers in these lines because they all have that Invictus DNA. So not everybody's favorite. This is probably the least sold one, least popular. You can find 3.4 ounces in that $50 range, tester bottles and full presentation bottles. I found this one at Marshall's, got a real good deal on it. That's why I have the 50 ml. Going to take me a long time to run through it probably, so the 50 ml is fine. Because it's not my favorite in the group either, but I have worn it and I will wear it. Underrated for sure in this line from the house. So what came out next was the one I'm missing, Invictus Aqua 2016 with the frosted glass. I'll put a picture of it right here. From what I understand, it's the better performer. It's a little more synthetic than the re-released version of Invictus Aqua. And it's fetching a pretty penny. They only released it for the summer of 2016. It's one of those that I had multiple chances to buy it while it was widely available. I had no idea it was going to be a limited summer release because I'm kicking myself and really regret not buying it when I had the chance. Because one bottle goes a long way with me because I have a lot of fragrances. I can wear something throughout a summer. It might take only get a few wears through that summer, so it's going to take me years to go through the bottle. But I might break down one of these days and get it because I'm a completionist. The collector in me wants to get it. I just hate to spend. Like, the cheapest I've seen it lately is like $150, $160, something like that. It's crazy to me for a fragrance that when it was widely available, I could get for $60 at discounters. But it is what it is. So the one I do have, the re-release Invictus Aqua 2018, Summer Compliment Magnet. Women love this fragrance. Everybody loves this fragrance. Those that hate on this fragrance are just hating the hate. This is great. Right now, on TLTG Reviews Fragrance Lounge, there's a raffle going on, $4.50 a spot. There's still 7 spots available because, of course, even though I don't need a bottle, you see how much I have in this tester bottle. Backup bottle worthy to me. There's 90 milliliters left. I believe the level's right around here for what's in that bottle. It's worth a shot. $4.50 to get 3.04 ounces, I think, is what 90 milliliters equates to. 3 ounces of Invictus Aqua 2018. Those of you that haven't signed up for that, get in the group. Get on it. It'll fill up quick. Must buy fragrance. This is the summer flanker of the line. I've never worn this and not got a compliment. I did an individual review on this one. I love the original Invictus more than any other fragrance, and I haven't done an individual review on that because there's so many out there. And there's a bunch of this one as well, but this one is just the most widely praised one of the flankers that are still available. So not the best performance of the group. I get 7 hours on my skin, but I get great, you know, very good projection early on. I get a good scent bubble that follows me for several hours. It doesn't really become a skin scent on me till about that 5.5-6 hour mark, which for a summer aquatic fragrance like this, that's very good performance, especially in the price point. I bought this tester bottle for $52. Forgot how long ago. The same seller. It's a fragrance company local in Houston. Now they're $47. They dropped another $5 or $6 from what I paid for it. So they're still readily available. Luckily, this wasn't a summer release. You can get them everywhere. I know for those of you that aren't in the South like myself, I'm in Houston, Texas. It's hot. We can still wear summer fragrances. We still got plenty of time to wear summer fragrances. It's freshy time of year most of the year for us. We can get away with wearing this all the way to the beginning of November. Really and truly. Aside from a few days that'll get cold or chilly, not really cold in October, we can wear this all the way till damn near Thanksgiving. You know, inoffensive. People love it. Smells great. If you haven't got your nose on it, get down to your local Macy's, Dillard's, Sephora, any of them that carry it. It's widely available. This is awesome. If you want to get your hands on one cheap, get in the raffle. TLTG Reviews Fragrance Lounge. Link's in the description, I'm telling you. Now's a good chance to get your hands on it for cheap. And then finally, the newest release, 2019. People say it's a mixture of these two, Invictus Intense and Invictus Aqua. I disagree. I think it's the most unique one in the line because it's so salty. The bay leaf is hyped up so much. What are we talking about? Invictus Legend. did a review on it last night. I'll actually tag that video right here if you want to go check that out. Enjoyed doing it. A lot to say about this, so I won't go down into the details on it. If you want to, just click that link right there. It'll take you to the video. Check it out. It's a great video. Wonderful fragrance. Another powerhouse in the line. Smells unique enough. Great release. Seems to be getting a good amount of praise, not too much hate, because there's a lot of haters in the fragrance world, just like there's a lot of haters in all other avenues of life, because haters are going to hate. I mean, it sounds cliche and corny, but it is what it is. Some people just can't help themselves. Can't just enjoy life. These are great. All of them. Everything you see here. I need to do some more organization. I know every video the pile's building and building, and I apologize for that. It might crack some of you up. I got to reorganize my shelving situation over there, because the earlier videos I would, you know, move stuff. Well, now it's just kind of piling up. But I enjoy doing it. It is what it is. So, fantastic line, guys. Like I said, if you want to check out more information about Invictus Legend, I just did a video on it last night. Click that information bar that I brought up, or it's the video right before. Just go to my channel page. But my absolute favorite line, these are all sweet fragrances. Invictus Aqua, not so sweet, more summery, aquatic, marine. You gotta like sweet fragrances to like stuff like this. They're not sickeningly sweet, but they're definitely on the, they lean on the sweet side, and they're powerhouses. Nothing subtle about these fragrances. For the more mature gentleman that doesn't really care for sweet fragrances or like just these big loud fragrances that aren't super crazy manly masculine, you know what I mean? Not full of oak moss and mint and cypress and all these manly notes and leather and stuff like that, this may not be for you guys. For me, damn near can't live without them. So as always, guys, do me a real quick favor. Go ahead and like, comment, subscribe. I appreciate all the feedback. I love reading the comments, chatting with everybody, loving that the group's going crazy lately. It's fun, guys. I really do appreciate all the support and everybody joining up on different things and subscribing to the channel, watching the videos, because I probably put out more content than most, because I do a video just about every single night. I think it's kind of rare that a night goes by and I don't do a video. Thank you to my wife for being such a good sport about it. She's in the room right now, so we can do this recording. And as always, guys, I say this a lot, but when it comes to this line, there's no doubt about it. You get your hands on these, I'll bet anything. You spray them now, you'll thank me later. Have a great evening, folks.